So we're looking here today at a set of five leather-bound volumes. And we have volumes 1 to 5 all in here. Conveniently, the titles are above the top of the box so you can see which volume is which. This is cowskin, which has a much smoother grain than goat or sheepskin. The lines here on the face are blind tooth, which means it's probably just heat and moisture with a wheel or line. There's direct goat tooling on the spine, and you apply a heated bronze or brass tooth in all the different patterns to get the impression in before dusting off the excess goat. And the corner pieces, each corner would have been the same tooth, which they then rotated to make on all sides. And then the left and right sides are the same tooth turned upside down. They were all constructed separately into this single panel because on the thinner volume, it has the same patterns, just in a slimmer format. And the red color is possibly vermilion, which is a dangerous pigment that made certain manuscript users go slightly insane due to the way they would lick their fingers to flip the pages. There's a pattern going across the board edges here on all three sides. This was most probably made using a wheel or a fillet and a suit from a candle or printer's ink dipped in boiling water. I have my own 18th century model binding that I made as a student that I can open and show you things with. These bumps on the spine here, which are also on these volumes, are caused by the supports, which are cords that the text block would be sewn on to help attach them to the boards. You line the spine up against the sewing frame where you hang your cords from, and you put your needle in and out around the cord. And once that sewing is done, they would do rounding and backing, which gives the spine this curved shape. This is to prevent what would happen sometimes when books sit on the shelf for too long, the spine goes in, and to avoid that, you make it go out to begin with. The gilding on the box is a lot neater and even because this is what would have been put on the shelf for presentation. We have more elaborate tooling on the box. You can see these are much bigger tools, which, you know, you need to have a lot of strength to apply these. Oh, and this would have been a wheel as well, this decorative element on the false bands. This is a different color leather than the rest of the box. It would be a very, very thinly paired piece of leather that was stuck on as a highlight, and then it would be direct tooth the same way as the rest of the box, and then a heated tooth applied to it directly without any pre-planning. Everything is done by hand with no markups, no projector telling you where each thing should go. This is just really practiced master hand.